pedestrians, completely like the concept of surveillance is best contained. In the previous classes, we discussed about what is SMQ, what is network, what is this state, what is rubies, what is time, and what is power and so on. And I've seen what is home stuff, and I've seen seal circles and others, of course. I've seen network creation and information analysis. Why is the mesh analysis we can find and through each element, and what is it as each element, and you can calculate the power also. Mesh analysis is one of the network creation techniques. Before this mesh analysis, we have Kirchhoff's current and Kirchhoff's voltage also. Why you get KC and KV also, we can reduce the inference. But for large networks and more number of loops, we can override the mesh analysis and nodal analysis. Mesh analysis is based on Kirchhoff's voltage law. And we will assume currents in each loop. We will write KV equations in each loop and we will solve the equations. We will get the current values. So that we can calculate current, voltage, and power, whatever we require in the circuit. Another method of network creation technique is nodal analysis. By using nodal analysis, also we can calculate voltage, current, and power, whatever may be what we require in the circuit. So, nodal analysis is based on Kirchhoff's current law. Here, in mesh analysis, we assume currents in each loop. Here, in nodal analysis, we will assume voltages in each loop. So, the following are the steps to follow to calculate for nodal analysis. First, we have to choose a reference node. So, in the previous mesh analysis, how many number of loops we are having in the circuit, we assume the reference currents. For example, if it is a 3-loop circuit, we assume 3 different currents. If it is a 4-loop circuit, we assume 4 currents. Similarly, in nodal analysis, first we will select a reference node. See this one, it may be any one of them. It may be a common, common, and charges, whatever it may be. We will select one, a reference node. See this one. For example, this is a circuit having 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes, and we have 3 nodes, first node, second node, third node. And we will select one reference node, that is called at the bottom. And the next step, assign node voltages to the nodes. See the various nodes we have, first node, second node, third node. So we will select voltages for the other nodes like this. Let us say this is V1 voltage, this is V2 voltage, this is V3 voltage. So next one, apply KCL to each node rather than reference node except currents in terms of node voltages. So for the value circuit, here we assume V1 voltage, V2 voltage, and V3 voltage. Except this reference voltage, we will assume other voltages V1, V2, V3. We write KCL at each node. We will express current in terms of voltages available here. See this one, for example, this 500 volt resistance is common to V1 and V2. So what would be the current equation? V1 minus V2 divided by 500 according to Ohm's law, V is equals to IR, I is equals to V1. So, current through 500 which is nothing but V1 minus V2 divided by 500. For example, only one resistor is available and another one is common. So, how to write the equation, current equation? Simply V1 minus 0. Reference node voltage is nothing but simply 0. So, V1 minus 0 divided by 500. This is also again Ohm's law. Next one, KCL probe 1. See this one. At KCL probe 1, we are doing it is connected with one panel which is connected to the ground, another panel which is connected to the another one which is V2. Then, how to write current equation? Here, I1 is nothing but V1 minus V2 divided by 500 plus V1 voltage divided by 500 volts. Right? Next one, see this another model. This is V1, V2, V3, and another 1 kilo of resistance. Then how to write equations? How to write current equations at node V2? V2 minus V1 divided by 500. So what is our equivalent to V1 V3 is 500. Similarly, V2 and V3, the voltage available between V2 and V3, the resistor is 500 ohms. Therefore, how do we write? V2 minus V3 divided by 500. Similarly, what is current at 1 kilo? Simply reference. No voltage V2, reference voltage is nothing but 0. Therefore, we can write V2 minus 0 on 1 kilo ohms. See, operate case I have this V3 and V2, and there is a 5 ohm resistance. And V3, we have another 5 ohm resistance. solving these three equations, we will get the node voltages V1, V2, V3. Based on these node voltages, we can easily calculate current, voltage, and power, whatever we require in the circuit. So this is the total circuit. This is the total circuit. We assume the reference voltage is called 0 volt at the bottom. Here the voltage is V1, here the voltage is V2, here the voltage is V3. Solution, what is the gain? 167 I1 plus 167 I2, if you solve the previous equations. Typical circuit for nodal analysis. Now see, this is another one. Actually, for this type of circuits, mesh analysis is very easy. But whatever the circuit we are having, you can apply both mesh analysis as well as nodal analysis. If you have a more number of loops, it is easy to go for mesh analysis. If you have more number of nodes, it is easy to go for nodal analysis. So based on the circuit, you can select the reduction method. It can be the mesh analysis or it can be the nodal analysis. If you are having more than, for example, take the circuit, if you go for a normal mesh analysis circuit, this requires first loop, second loop, third loop, and fourth loop. So if you assume four different values in case of mesh analysis, we will get four variables. Four variables are going to be somewhat difficult when compared to three variables. Whereas for the same circuit, if you apply nodal voltages, we will get only three equations. This is V1, V2, and V3. For only three variables. So based on the circuit available gain, we can select any network prediction technique. Either we will go for either mesh analysis or nodal analysis. That depends on the circuit. See this one, circuit A and circuit B. This more or less similar, but how can we assume current? Here simply if you go for mesh analysis, here we will have to assume I1 current, I2 current, I3 current. We will get three variables. Whereas if you apply same circuit nodal analysis, simply node voltage V1 and node voltage V2, and the difference is, of course, it is 0 volts of reference voltage. For the same circuit, if you apply mesh, you will get 3 variables. If you apply nodal analysis, you will get only 2 variables. So solving 2 variables is easy rather than solving 3 variables. So if you write 2 equations, KCL equations at each node, what you will get? For example, take this one. I2 current is leading, I1 current is leading, small I1 current is leading, big I1 current is entering. Therefore, what will be the equation? Here I1 current. So the amount of the incoming currents is equal to the amount of outgoing currents, that is data KCL. So large current I1 is nothing but I2 plus small I1 plus small I2. If you see this one, I3 current, see this I3 current is flowing through R3 resistance, right? So in case of R3, I3 current is nothing but sum of small I2 plus large I2 current. Therefore, I2 plus small I2 is equal to your I3. Then what will be your current? How can we write the current equation I potential voltage minus power potential voltage divided by resistance available at that particular branch. Therefore, what is I1 current? Where I1 current is flowing, I1 current is flowing through the resistor R1. Therefore, voltage available at resistance R1 is nothing but V1. Resistance is R1. Therefore, I1 is equal to V1 minus 0. Why we have taken 0 here? Here the reference voltage is nothing but 0. Or I1 is equal to Z1 and V1 to write in terms of conductance. Next, I2 current. I2 current is flowing through the resistor R2. This is common between V1 and V2. equation analysis here, we will get three equations, I am current, I am current, and I am current. Simply, if you go for a normal Nodal analysis, we will get only two nodes, first node and second node. We will see this. Next one, another concept is since up to stage A, verify the voltage of the nodes Q and B. See, this is another 2 ohms, this is another 2 ohms. Here is a pure independent source, the amperes. Here, 2 ICs, dependent source. So, what is this source? Current dependent current source. Right? So, these ICs are referencing current to 2 ohm resistor. This is another model of Nodal analysis. We will see how to solve these equations. Here, the incoming current is the amperes. Another current is I square, another current is nothing but I1. So here, yeah, this current is incoming current, this is not being R. Outgoing current is Ix, I1. So how to write same as previous, incoming current is equal to I1 is flowing through, I1 is flowing through both resistor. This is common to both V9 and V3. So V1 minus V3 divided by 4. So what is Ix current? Ix current is flowing through 2 ohms. So, I have 2 ohms is common to V1 and V2, therefore V1 minus V2 divided by 2 ohms. Next one, similarly at node 2. At node 2, we have 3 currents. So, Ix current is incoming, I3 and I2 are outgoing currents. As per KCL, Ix is nothing but I2 plus I3. We can write Ix value. Ix is from the 2 ohms here, we are considering difference from. Therefore, V1 minus V2 divided by 2 is equal to I2 current is flowing to input resistor. So V2 minus V3 divided by S, I3 current is going to 4 ohm resistor. Voltage divided by 4 ohms is nothing but V2. V2 divided by 4. 0 means difference in voltage. Similarly, at node 2, we have 3 currents. 2 incoming currents and 1 incoming current. I1 and I2 incoming currents. 2x current is outgoing current. So I1 current is nothing but flowing through V1 and common to V1 and V3. Is nothing but 4 ohms. We can write V1 minus V3 by 4. That's I2 current is flowing through 8 ohm resistor. Similarly, we can write V2 minus V3 divided by 2. Similarly, 2 into I is our APS delta. I is current is flowing through 2 ohms, which is common to V1 and V2. V1 minus V2 divided by 2. So, if you write in the matrix form, we will get these three equations. By solving these equations, we can calculate V1, V2, and V3. So that we can calculate current source. See another concept. If current sources are available in the circuit, we can easily go for Nodal analysis. If we have any voltage sources in the circuit, it is somewhat difficult.
those ones.